Hi, I'm Debbie, and welcome to Divine Destiny with Debbie. Today we're reading for August 30th, 31st, September 1st, and 2nd. That's Monday through Thursday. Now, I'm using my Radley Valentine decks. I will use my Archangel Power Tarot cards for the main message. I will use my Angel Tarot cards for just pull one, kind of see what else it can say. I will also pull from my Emily Anderson Crystal deck. Now, I've prayed, meditated, infused all the decks with Reiki energy. Just remember that this is a general reading. It may or may not resonate. Take what you like, leave the rest. I am an intuitive channeler. I open myself to higher power. My job is just to deliver the message no matter what. Remember, reversed cards have a little more meaning. When I speak about higher power, you know, to you, that could be higher power, guardian angel, spirit guide, voice of the universe, your divine, the source, whoever that is to you, that's your personal journey. Okay? Okay. Now, I've also pulled out my guardian angel cards, and I do feel that we need to have a little bit of encouragement for this week. We do have Libra, or Mercury is transversing into Libra, and that will be on the 30th. Now, Mercury in Libra, Libra has a lot of justice energy. It has a lot of right and wrong energy. It has a lot of, the sword energy. And think about the sword. The sword cuts through the air. The sword is what, you know, again, right through wrong type of thing. It will be, Mercury is about communications. Mercury is also about business, electronic issues also, or electronics, I should say. Mercury is going to be in Libra for a little over 2 months. So it's going to be an interesting time. So it'll be there from August 30th until November 5th. It also goes retrograde around the 27th. And I think it's the 27th. And then that's a whole different thing. And we'll talk about that as we get closer, because that will actually be in Libra season. So again, honesty and communications. Remember, yes, I know, Saturn is in Aquarius, and that's illusion versus reality. So there could be some interesting things coming over, the communications, things being very brutally honest. I do feel that Mercury will probably not have a lot of tact. I think it's just going to be right there in your face. So now, I have shuffled, I have cut. We're going to pull just one card and see what we might have, just an overlying energy for this week. Here we go. Choose freedom. Now that's interesting with this. So this is a 15. Lots and lots of change energy here. Lots of change energy. You know, 5 is about change, positive, negative. 5s also have grace. So there's a lot of things that maybe we don't deserve it, but you know, a lot of times the universe does give us grace through these times. So again, so we have the 15. 1 is a new beginning. You can look at it as a 10 plus 5. 10 would be your transition. And like I said, 5 is change. Change, positive, negative, neutral. Okay, choose freedom. Sometimes you may feel as though your way is blocked, but often that's just an illusion. Remember, illusion versus reality. You could free yourself from the obstacles that you are so focused on by choosing a different path. Turn your thoughts away from negativity and instead envision endless other possibilities you might act upon. Oh my goodness. I think that that's very powerful words. I think that we need to remember what that is. I think I also need to bring down my camera a little bit. Sorry about that. But again, choose freedom. And it does bring to mind, I've been trying to do some blogging on my my website. And what I'll do is many times I'll find other articles and I will reference those. You'll actually see the links to the articles, and I'll do a couple of paragraphs on my thoughts. There was an article that I think was last week or the end of the week before, and it was called David and Goliath. If you have not read it, please read it, because it does explain a lot of things that are going on right now. Okay. Anyway, we need to make sure that we keep our thoughts positive, that we do not feed the dark energy with fear, and we just keep going forward with the light that we are. Okay? Okay. Let's start our readings now. Hello, my Aries. How are you doing? Oh, are you getting set? Are you getting set? Get ready. I'm kind of getting that, on your mark, get set, go type of energy for you again. Let's see what this is all about. Okay. The High Priestess is already, okay, you want to come out too? Sure. The High Priestess is coming out. That is Archangel Heniel. That is a number two. Twos have crossroads, decisions. Twos are also coming together, and twos are also, connecting, well, with the High Priestess, connecting with your higher power, whoever that is. There's also, a lot of people have been saying this. We know that, you know this. There's also, we got more cards that are flying out. Anyway, oh, look at that. Let's see how we're going to put these out here. We're going to put them like this. Well, you can't see that. Anyway, there's a lot of ascension energy going. Be aware that it's not comfortable, but it's, again, get on your, like I said, get on your mark, get set, go. Things are happening around you. Your intuition, I would say, trust your intuition, trust your gut, trust that little voice that tells you if you're driving and it says, pull over for a moment. And you go, well, I don't understand, but no, pull over for a moment. Trust your intuition, okay? So that's about the High Priestess with that. Now, just be prepared. It's not comfortable. People are like, oh, I love this. No, it's not always comfortable because you know things about people that maybe you didn't want to know. But it doesn't always mean that you have to tell them unless you really are feeling very directed to do that. Okay. Anyway, powerful psychic insights, reflection and meditation that provides valuable information. Be at peace. Next card. This one's reversed. The World. Okay. So now we have a 2 and we have a 2-1. So we know what the 2s are all about. 1s are new beginnings, new starts. The World is Archangel Michael. Michael is the warrior, the protector. He's the one that, he is the one that gets out there and fights a lot of battles. But at the same time, the World is saying things are coming together for you. The job well done. Things are happening the way they need to happen. Congratulations. So this is kind of stepping into a lot of power for you also. And it might be stepping into your own power. It might be getting a promotion. If we're going into more of the natural world, it might be getting getting a promotion, new job, new money, a raise type of energy here. If it is the supernatural, which there's a lot of supernatural power right here. Again, there's this increase in your intuition, increase in your ascension type of energy. There's a lot of talk about going from a 3D to a 4D to a 5D. Again, there's a lot of stretching in this week for you. Do with it what you will. Anyway, it's a very happy ending, coming full circle, spiritual growth and insight. Now, your next cards here, these are the cards that fell out also. And I don't know what the, oh my gosh, okay. So now let's go here. This is the next one. This is 8. 8 has unlimited opportunities, possibilities, justice. Now, justice is a lot to do with what I was talking about in the introduction, okay, with Mercury and Libra. So there's a lot of, communication, a lot of speaking out, a lot of justice coming with, right truthfulness type of energy. Now, this is Archangel Raguel. So you have 2, 2, 1, and an 8. So this is about, again, if this is legal, I am not a lawyer, so do not take this as legal advice. Go see a lawyer about this. But this is about fight for justice and equality. Rulings made in your favor. Don't give up. There's a lot of karma being balanced, a lot of karma that's actually being released also. And we've talked about this. There's certain times, hot spots that, come, and it's like, this is one of those times. This is more the time for you, my Aries. Something's happening for you where there is this karma being released, karma being balanced. A lot of that has to do with a lot of the Libra energy around you. Okay, so let's go on here. Let's see what else we have. So here's the other 2 cards, and this is the one, again, reversed. And this is a 0. 0 is God, source, divine type of energy. This is leap of faith. This is new beginnings. This is you have to not to necessarily believe in your own abilities, though I'm not telling you not to. Your abilities and who you are have brought you here. but also to believe in a higher power type of energy, a higher power abilities. So this is believe in yourself. So I said, you know, but except, like I said, there is more going on. There has a lot to do with crown chakra here. Okay, listen to your heart. Do what gives you joy. So we have a 22180. And then we come, this is the last card that fell out of this deck, and it is the Knight of Gabriel. Now, Knight's underlying energy is fire. This Gabriel is fire. So this is fire, fire. Knights are very directional. You know, they go where you're pointing them. The Knight of Fire, that, you know, fire, fire. This is passionate. This is do. You know, this is not time for you to just sit. This is time for you to do. This is time for you to make things happen, but also to connecting with your higher power, because it's not just you that makes things happen. It's, you know, miracles can happen. Miracles can make things happen. So this is, again, time for you to get busy, time for you to do. I kind of get the do-do. Well, you need to do. Okay. Anyway, here it is. Confident, enthusiastic, courageous, charismatic. Time to take action, great passion for a cause, instinctively knowing just what to do. Now, remember, we have Heniel, we have Michael, we have Raguel, and we have Metatron. So there's very strong energies around you, very strong arc energy, and now it's time for you to partner with all of that divine energy and get busy. Okay, this week could be really... This week could be a little bit overwhelming to you. It's not a time for you to sit down. It's not a time for you to be, you know, static. This is, get on your mark, get set, go. Let's see. And anything with the numbers, do they jump out at you? I mean, the twos do. The 1-8 does. The zero does. I mean, it's 2-2-1-8-0. Something going on for you, my Aries. Let me know. Comment. Here we are. Let's go on. One card from this deck. This one is going to be reversed. Let's see what this is. The Seven of Water. Now, water energy is our Scorpio. It is our Pisces. It's Cancer, fluid, emotional, spiritual energy. This is very spiritual energy. Sevens is the divine number, is divine umbrella. There is that connection with the divine, with the sevens. There is, like, what are you going to do with this type of energy all around you? These are choices. We all have choices. Now, sometimes we can say, not this week, not this week. Or we can say, okay, whatever I need to do, I need to do. I will always say, though, with, you know, just as the seven gives you that divine umbrella, whenever you're going on to, whenever you're being called into a spiritual matter, ask your higher power to cover you in the cloak of protection. Okay? It's very simple. Just whenever I am going into any kind of a situation where I'm going to be dealing more with the spiritual, more with the supernatural, as opposed to the natural, cover me with your cloak of protection. I say that to my higher power all the time. But these are some choices. Seems like it's going to be some big choices here too. Okay, a complex decision, the need to do research, stop procrastinating. Like I said, time to do. It's time to do. Get on your mark, get set, go. You are the only one that's had my Aries. I still have Leo to do, but you're the only one I think that's had the archangels coming out, or at least not to this extent. I don't remember. Did anyone have archangels? I don't know. Maybe one or two, but like I said, you're the one that has this really pushing at you. Again, the numbers are jumping, and now we have a seven. So what does that mean? Let me know. Here we go. What crystal or energy will be helpful for my Aries? Here we go. Shungite. Well, that makes sense. Shungite is very good at grounding you. It's also good at protecting you from EMF, electromagnetic field forces. It's very good at protecting you from that. Protection from modern ills, grounding, everyday healing, but it's also good for purifying. If you're going to have all those angels around you, I guess you need to have some purification. Anyway, also too, for some reason, drink some water, but make sure it's purified water. A lot of times those chemicals, they block your third eye, your third eye chakra, your third eye. Okay, so my Aries, this is really interesting. I want to know what this is all about. Good luck to you with it. Very strong, possibly overwhelming, but encouraging type of energy here. Okay, remember to like, share, subscribe, click on the bell for notifications. And regardless of whatever the world is throwing at you this week, my Aries, always know that you are loved, stay shining, and be blessed. Bye-bye.